Hello, my name is Jason Vorpagel. This is my video blog on one of the music industry's most life-saving yet underappreciated technological marvels. No, I'm not talking about the studio intern who gets you coffee. I'm talking about the Digital Audio Workstation, also known as the DAW. Up until about 25 years ago, if you were to work in a major studio, everyone recorded on 2-inch tape. Problem was, 2-inch tape is really expensive. The tape machines cost you an arm and a leg and sometimes one of your kidneys, and they require a heck of a lot of upkeep. There was no such thing as automated faders or anything like that. If you wanted to mix down, you got everyone on deck, interns, and sometimes even Bubba the janitor, and they all rode the faders as you went through the whole mix down process. All hands on deck.
Wise men say only fools rush in.
The Digital Audio Workstation created something very unique. Instead of having to have a tape-based, gigantic studio room, you could get all of your audio mixed in high fidelity on a little tiny computer. Well, now the computers are little tiny. Back then, they were freaking huge. But that's another story. A DAW is essentially a computer-based mixing board console like you would see in a studio. However, instead of having a gigantic board made by SSL or Neve or Midas, it's all wrapped up nice and pretty
in a little tiny package, really, really small.
And on your computer screen. The systems are tapeless and instead are based on microprocessors. Now you basically have two kinds of DAWs. The earliest stage of a DAW was called the integrated DAW. It consisted of a mixing console, control surface, audio converter, and data storage on one device. But as personal computers became powerful enough to perform software DAWs, that's a lot of P's in one sentence.
That's a plethora of P's?
The price of software DAWs decreased. Well, what's a software DAW? A software DAW has four basic components. A computer, a sound converter, a digital audio editor, and at least one input device. The computer is the host for the sound card and the software that actually processes all the audio information. And the higher fidelity you get, sometimes you can get up to 192 kilohertz at 32-bit.
Oh, sonic purity. Pretty.
Now that's just a bunch of fancy talk for what a DAW actually does. It allows you to record in a multi-track format, mono, stereo, whatever. Edit all the takes down, mix them using the plugins that you have on your computer, even master them, and create a professional high-quality mix of music, all in your computer. Essentially, it took the control of who gets to make a record and who doesn't out of the hands of studio and label executives and put it into the very eager and often sweaty hands of the average musician. Now there were a lot of attempts early on in the late 70s to create DAWs, but computer hardware was so limited, didn't go very far. In the mid to late 1980s, two guys named Gerhard Lingerling and Chris Adams created a MIDI-based sequencer program. It was designed for the Atari ST, yeah, there's a throwback, and it was called Creator. Essentially, this MIDI-based software evolved into what we commonly know now as Apple's Logic Pro. At roughly the same time, 1984, dun dun dun, two UC Berkeley graduates were designing a program called Sound Designer. Sound Designer's focus was actually audio files, not MIDI, but the tracking of audio wave files. That program, Sound Designer, is what evolved into DigiDesign's Pro Tools. Because of the affordability of software-based DAWs and the increasing performance of computers, many of the major studios ended up transferring from the tape-based recording process to the digital audio workstation. Competition is stiff. There are over 30 commercial digital audio workstations on the market today. But even still, there are quite a few freeware versions of DAWs as well. Not bad if you're a poor musician, like most of us. Now for me, as a blossoming producer, whatever you want to call me, I could not do what I'm doing without a digital audio workstation. I think the DAW is to audio recording what the cell phone is to communication. It puts it in the hands of the common man. Can you hear me now? The ability for me to go in and actually produce music in a studio would be pretty much non-existent, especially in the town that I live in. If you like the desert, and you like khaki, Tri-Cities, Washington is for you. But if you're a normal human being, you probably need to go to a major metropolitan area to get to a professional grade studio. A good DAW does not guarantee a professional sounding mix. That comes with education, training, understanding, technical expertise, engineering abilities, a good ear, a lot of times just flat out talent or gifting. I'm trying to compensate for the former with what I lack in the latter. Still in all, we would not be able to do music today were it not for the inventors of the DAW, a technological breakthrough in the world of audio recording. Again, this is Jason Vorpagel, and thanks for watching. I'm looking. Bear with me.
But I made a CD on the software that my mommy bought me for Christmas, and she says I'm the best singer ever.
Get off my bloody set. You suck.
It's that, yeah.